Insight.
The first ever series to analyze the unexplored aspects and issues of Carnatic music. Dear Rasikas, welcome to the 9th episode of our Insight series. Till now, we discussed various topics including the structure of Carnatic music, its components, raga, tala, the composition and so on. Another very, very important element of Carnatic music is the Manodharma Sangeeta, that is the area where the artist displays his virtuosity, his creativity. In Carnatic music, we see that there are very many channels also for the expression of this Manodharma Sangeeta, namely Raga Alapana, Tanam, Niraval and Swaram. Of course, the element of Tanam is generally attached to Veena playing, where you see that the Vainika would play a Ragam, Tanam and the composition. And in the vocal tradition, we see that the Tanam is more a part of the Ragam, Tanam, Pallavi combo, and generally artists do not sing Tanam to Kritis. We will now first take up Raga Alapana, which is one of the most exquisite element of Carnatic music. Theoretically, we see that Sambamurthy, one of the great musicologists, has defined Raga Alapana as Sangraha Alapana and Sampurna Alapana. But all this is very, very relative in the sense that what is the time duration of a Sangraha Alapana or a Sampurna Alapana depends very much on the duration of the concert, the artist's choice and very many more things. As to the proportion, generally we see that when we are singing a small Kriti, we would not do a very, very elaborate Alapana, in the sense that if the Kriti is just about 3 minutes, we wouldn't be doing about half an hour or 45 minutes Alapana to it. Generally, the expansive kind of Raga Alapana, which is done in a stage by stage, is more done to the main piece of the concert, which is most often in a Rendikala Kriti, which we take for presentation actually. So here we see that the artist would resort to a very methodical, a very elaborate way of presenting the Raga Alapana, followed by the Kriti, then the Niraval, Swaram and a detailed Tani Avartanam. Coming back to the domain of Manodharma Sangeeta, we see that words have not only brought about variety in musical material, but also played an important role in the formation of the musical forms itself. And relative importance of raga and words form the basis. Thus, it could be said that the raga is like a fluid and it takes the shape of the container into which it is put, in the sense that if the same raga, Kalyani, is put into the container called Alapana, then that form is taken. If it isn't put into a container called Niraval, it will take the shape of the Niraval. If it is put into the container of Kalpanaswaram, it will be so on. Now, what is the material of the Raga Alapana? Here we see that Ta, Da, Ri, Na, these kind of syllables are used to create various kinds of patterns. Now here, Ta, Da, Ri, there are here Akaras, Ikara, and we see that it's also mixes with consonants, and thus we have different combinations of these words which are used to weave out a beautiful pattern called the Raga Alapana. In Niraval, what is happening is that we often take the lyrical material for the Niraval from the composition itself. For example, if you are singing the composition Shambho Mahadeva in Panturali, then you will be taking up a line from that composition only for Niraval. This is very, very obvious. Obviously, why I am saying this is that you wouldn't be singing the composition and then taking up the Niraval of some other composition to do the elaboration. That's what I wanted to mention here. Now, coming back to Raga Alapana, We see that when you are doing it as an elaborate form, every note is explored to its maximum limit, in the sense that gradually, you know, it's more like an unfolding process also, I would say, where first of all, we try to create a sketch of the ragam through limited phrases. Then we go to the mandra sthayi and slowly establish the shadja. And then note by note, we try to develop the ragam, reach the tarasthayi shadja, then the upper octave, that is the tarasthayi. And then after that, a lot of fast phrases, slow phrases, all these are intermingled to create the alapana. And finally, we come back to the sa, then try to wind off by giving some phrases, and finally the alapana ends. So here you see that what is important is that a beautiful structure is created here. I just like to show you a small alapana to show you the method of progression. We'll take Purvi Kalyani for example. This is only a very small sample, but what I want to show you here is how the gradually from note to note we try to develop the ragam. Here I would also like to add the changing trends that I observe. Earlier we used to see that when we sing a main item, most often ragas like Kalyani, Shankarabharanam, Saveri, Todi, Karaharapriya, these were the ragas which were explored. And only if these kind of ragas were taken, it was also acceptable. But today, artists seem to expand their vistas of creativity, and it is not surprising to see somebody sing a Vagadishwari or a Dhenuka or a Ganamurte even as the main item by taking it as part of the Ragam Thanam Pallavi. So that way we see that earlier, though we did say that certain ragas do offer expansive treatment and some ragas do not have scope, today we see that the intellectual level of artists has reached a very, very high level, and many ragas which were not explored in its full form earlier are now given a lot of exploration and a lot of focus as well. Coming to the next aspect about Neraval. Neraval is, to put it very simply, taking a theme line from a song and trying to create patterns with the lyrical material. Here, it's also important to remember that when you take a line for Neraval, it should carry some good meaning. For example, if you take 80 Janmam Idiha and you sing 80 Janmam Idi Yendugu Galikino, Yeti Janmamidi means, what is this life? He's trying to express his frustration. So if you're going to repeat that same line again and again, it may not augur well with the audience. So taking the names of gods, goddesses, and some good thought for Nerival makes a lot of more sense. We look into one example to see how Nerival is done. I will take the example of Keeravani and show you in Sri Purari Rani Keeravani in the song Nee Charanambuja. In this composition, Sri Purari Rani Keeravani, Sri Purari Rani Keeravani, Sri Rama Vani Nuta Sukha Pani, Sri Purari Rani. Shri Purari Rani Keeravani, Shri Rama Vani Nuta Sukha Pani, Shri Purari Rani. This is what we call as the Samakala Nerival. After that you will have the next tempo of Nerival. Shri Purari Rani Keeravani, Shri Rama Vani Nuta Sukha Pani, Shri Purari Rani. Like this it keeps going. Here what is important to remember is that while Tadharina becomes a common material, whether you sing a Todi, Shankarabarnam, Bhairavi, Dhenuka or whatever, here the Nerival, the composition gives the material, in the sense that now I sang Nee Charanambuja where this was the Nerival line. In the same Keeravani, you take another example of Kaligi Yunde, you would see that the Nerival theme would be like Baguga Shiragu Rabuni Pada Mula Baguga Shiragu. Let us take another example of Kalyani. Suppose I take the composition Nammi Vachina. There the Nerival line probably most suitable would be Nadarupa Shri Saundarya Nayakipate Nadarupa. Or if you take Eta Unara Sita Gauri Vageshwari. Or if you take the composition Unna Yellal Veregati of Papanasan Sivan Niye Meenakshi Kamakshi Neelayadakshi Yenna Palapeyarudal Yagu Niye Meenakshi. So, though all of them, the examples I gave you were in Kalyani, or if you take another example of Dikshadar Kamalambam Bajare Kabalam Bam Bhajare Ramanasa. So in each of these cases, though we see that all of them had Kalyani as a common material, the structure of each composition, the structure of each line gives that scope for different ways of exploring the lyrics in terms of the rhythmic aspects. So that's where the Nerival is a very, very unique form. The next we come to Kalpanaswarams. Kalpanaswarams, again the raw material here are the seven notes, Sarigama Padani in its various combinations. Some ragas, of course, as we mentioned earlier, take all these notes. In some ragas, some of the notes may be absent. So with the available notes as permissible by the ragam, we see that the permutation combination is created. We'll take one example of Purvi Kalyani and the line Paadi Madhi Jodi and see how Kalpanaswaras are performed.
Paadi madhi jodi palir palirena padashilam boli galir galir gena paadi madhi jodi pamagare gama paadi madhi jodi gama dasani dada pama paadi madhi da da ba 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 da ba ma da ba ma ga ma ba di ma di da da ri ri sa ni da da sa ni da sa ni da pa ni da da ba ma ga ma ba di ma di ro di pa ma ga da ba ma ga ni da pa ma ga sa ni da pa ma pa di ma di ro di ga ga ma ma ga ga da da ga ga sa ni da ni da pa pa da ma pa di ma di ro di.
So what we are actually doing here is trying to create permutation combinations of the swaras to create different patterns. Now what I sang was very, very simple patterns, but the great stalwarts have worked years on end, I would say, to find out the innumerable combinations that are possible in the swaras. And this swara, after that, we see that they perform what is called the kuraipu, that is where every long phrase of singing the swaras, after that, you know, it ends in a culmination on a particular point. It may be first in about 4 avartas, then it will be decreased to 2 avartas, then 1 avarta, then half, then quarter, and then after that what happens is we traverse the entire gamut of the ragam and finally end into what we call as a korve. So that way the Kalpanaswaram itself has a very, very beautiful form in terms of the progression of the notes. Here I would like to make an important comparison of Carnatic music with the counterpart Hindustani music, in the sense that in Carnatic music we can always perform a composition by itself also without the Manodharma. And again, the choice of Manodharma also depends on the artist. For example, I may choose to do Raga Alapana for a composition, for another I may just do Neraval Swaram, or I may just keep to singing Swaram to another composition. So there is actually nothing rigid about that. If you sing this composition, you have to sing a Raga Alapana, Neraval and Swaram to it. In fact, there are compositions, I would say, like Akhilandeshwari in Dvajavanti or an Avagraha Kriti of Dikshadhar, which are so replete with the ragam that sometimes you feel that, okay, even I just remember Rangapura Vihara of Dikshadhar, where singing the composition itself seems very, very complete and you really need not add anything much to it. That is the kind of raga exposition that has come through the composition. Coming back to Hindustani music, seldom or rather never would you see that the composition is presented by itself. A composition itself means that all the Manodharma elements has to go with it. That means the Raga Alapana, the Bada Khyal, the Chota Khyal, and sometimes followed by a Tarana. So it's actually a compact whole where the Manodharma and the composition have to be woven together to create a piece. That is one difference I would like to share. And the second thing is about in Hindustani music, where you present a Bada Khyal followed by a Chota Khyal, and both of them share a commonality in terms of the ragam. For example, if the Bada Khyal is in Yaman, the Chota Khyal which follows would also be in Yaman. But seldom do we, or rather we would never see such a happening in our kacheri, where two songs are performed in the same ragam. Exception to this, I would say, is only the tradition of where you sing an Adatala Varnam in a particular ragam. And in earlier days, this was the trend where if I sang an Adatala Varnam in Kalyani, probably you could anticipate that I will sing a Ragam Thanapallavi in the same Kalyani. Or if I sing a Adatala Varnam in Todi, you could anticipate that I would sing a Ragam Thanapallavi in that. But this trend is not any more in existence, I would say. This kind of a tradition is not seen now. But then this has also been there to give an indication to the audience as to what could they expect in terms of the main raga for the day. To sum up, I would say that in Carnatic music, the Manodharma and the compositional part, that is the Kalpita Sangeetam, the two elements blend seamlessly, I would say. And the structure is such that it offers different levels of exposition, in the sense that a composition can be rendered by itself without the aid of the Manodharma. The composition can also have any choice of the Manodharma element, that is, you may do Alapana, you may do Raga Alapana, you may do Niraval, you may do Swaram, you may do all of it. So that way the composition also lends itself to explore the artist's imagination and his technical virtuosity. With this, we come to the end of today's episode. If you have any questions or feedback, you may please WhatsApp or email to me. I'm sure you found this session interesting. Please do keep sharing your views with us. Thank you very much.